वेलकम टू द वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ डिज़ाइन ऑफ स्टील स्ट्रक्चर्स फॉर थर्ड ईयर सिविल इंजीनियरिंग। आई एम सुधीर बी गायके, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग, संजीवनी कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, कोपरगांव। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड रिगार्डिंग बेयरिंग टाइप ऑफ बोल्टेड कनेक्शंस, स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ बोल्ट्स एंड कैपेसिटी और नॉमिनल कैपेसिटी ऑफ बोल्ट्स। इन द current video we are going to start with second type of connection, and that is welded type of connections. In this welded type of connection video we are going to see introduction to welded connections, advantages and disadvantages of welded connection, types of welds and specifications of weld as per IS 800 2007. So introduction to welded connections: when two structural members are connected by means of weld, the said connection is called as welded connection. So for reference we have considered this particular figure. So in the figure, two elements, element 1 and element 2, are connected with the help of this vertical welding. So the elements to be connected are brought close to each other, and the metal is melted by the means of electrical arc or oxyacetylene flame along with weld rod, which acts as a filler material to the joint, and after cooling the bond is formed between the parent material and the connected element. So here you need to understand, two materials are connected or fixed with each other with the help of electrical rod and electric current, which is melting the parent material as well as new material, and the electric rod is acting as a filler material to form a complete joint. So this particular welded type of joint is having certain advantages compared with the previous one, that is bolted type of joints. So here intense heat is produced. Here intense heat is produced to reduce the metal into liquid state by an electrical arc. This heat at the tip of rod melts the filler material and the base metal, thus by liquefying them into common pool called as carter. So this vertical particular line or tapered line is called as your carter, where welding is done. So in the next slide we'll see the advantages and disadvantages. So advantages of welded connections: so due to absence of cover plates, gusset plates or connecting angles, the connection is lighter. So in the previous type of connection, that is bolted connection, we have seen that additional plates are required either from the one side or two sides for accommodating your bolts, so which is ultimately increasing the self weight of your joint. So in this case of welded connection, such kind of gusset plates or cover plates are not required. Therefore, weight of your joint is going to reduce or connection is going to be lighter. And next is, no holes are required, so the process is fast. So as in case of your bolted connection, compulsory holes are required. So for welding connection, holes are not required. Therefore, the process is faster compared with the bolted connection. Then these particular joints are more adaptable than bolting type of connection, as the process is easier one. Now here again, efficiency up to 100% can be achieved in case of welded connection. So in case of bolted connection, efficiency cannot be achieved up to 100%, as there is certain reduction in area, and net area of your cross section or cross section of plate is reduced, which is ultimately reducing the strength of plate. So in this particular cases, no holes are drilled. Therefore, we can achieve the efficiency of 100%. Now again, appearance and elegance of this welded joint is good. So that is a common thing in case of your plates or gusset plates, cover plates, elegance is not proper, which can be achieved in case of welded connection. Now again, one more important advantage is these particular joints are airtight and gas tight. So usually many water tanks or gas tanks or liquid fuel tanks are usually constructed with the help of this particular welded type of joint, as this particular is completely leak proof or it is completely gas tight. Now again, the joints are rigid one, that is advantages. And next, alteration and future expansion is easy compared with bolted connection. So easy alteration or future expansion of existing structure can be done in comparison with your bolted connection. Now some of the disadvantages of welded connection: so as the joints are over rigid, there is chances of brittle kind of fracture, as it is going to show lesser amount of ductility because of its over rigidness. So possibility of direct failure is there in case of welded joints. Now again, the inspection of these particular welded joints is to be done with the help of NDT, that is non-destructive testing. While in case of bolted connection, it can be just seen by with the help of observation or inspection visually, which is not possible in case of your welded joint. Just by seeing the type of weld or the length of weld, we cannot predict that particular strength. And in order to predict the strength of that joint, non-destructive testing is to be required. Therefore, this process is somewhat lengthier one, and that is the disadvantages of welded connection. Now, in case of welded joints, certain skilled labors are required, which is also disadvantages for this particular method. Now, next point that we are going to see, types of welded joints. So, two complete figures we are seeing here. First is butt type of weld. So, in case of bolted joint, also two types of joints we have seen, lap joint and butt joint. So, the difference between lap and butt joint was, if the members to be connected are kept end to end, they are called as, they are coming under the category of butt joint. And here also similar type of weld we are using, that is butt weld, where the members to be connected are kept or lined up in front of each other. So butt weld, it is also known as, groove welding and adapted when joints are lined up. So here you will consider this particular is first parent material and this is your second parent material, which are to be connected with the help of this joint. And this joint or groove weld is nothing but that is your square type of welding. So this welding type are classified based on this particular five types, and all these categories are based on the depth of penetration of weld. So here in the first type you can understand it is a square type of joint where entire thickness is filled with the help of welding. Now second is a single V type welding, third is double V type welding, fourth type is single U type of welding, and fifth type is double U type of welding. And on the above lines we have shown that these are the throat thicknesses of your welding sections. So in case of your square joint, thickness or throat thickness is equal to total thickness of material. Here it is 5/8 of thickness, here it is again equal to complete thickness, here it is 5/8 to 7/8 to throat thickness, thickness of thinner part. And next is your W, here also total throat thickness is equal to T value. Now all these calculations are required in order to calculate the throat thickness of your welding size. So this is in case of your butt kind of weld. Now second type of welding we are going to see, second type of welding is fillet welding. So here the difference is, in case of butt weld, the members to be connected were lined up, and in case of fillet welding, the orientation of the element to be connected is different. So orientation of parent material, here it is shown, orientation of parent material is horizontal one and the member to be connected is vertical one. So when these are used, when two members are to be connected in different planes, the situation is frequently occurs within the structure, therefore are most commonly used. So here two different orientations of element are to be connected, for that case we are adopting fillet kind of weld. So these are classified depending upon the shape of weld face. So either it may be convex shape, first type, then it is concave shape, and third is mitre. So likewise three classification is there, and one similar figure I have drawn here, which is showing us this particular leg size, vertical leg size, horizontal leg size, and yellow color is shown with the help of throat thickness. Now this throat thickness is required for calculating the strength of weld. Now if you consider this particular figure, if you consider this particular right angle triangle, and this yellow color line is showing us the throat thickness of weld place. Now again that throat thickness or yellow color line is making an angle of 90 degree with the hypotenuse. Therefore we are getting angle equal to 45 degree on the other side. So it is a right angle triangle again. So 90 degree with the hypotenuse and 45 degree at your opposite sides. Therefore for a right angle triangle, if you are making sine of 45, so throat thickness will be equal to 0, sine of 45 is value 0.70 size of welding. So therefore for calculating the strength of welding, always throat thickness is 0.7 times of size of weld. So I will repeat, always throat thickness will be size of welding multiplied by 0.7 value. Now next is slot and plug welding. So these are used to supplement the fillet welding. So usually in some circumstances you cannot provide the required length of welding, and for that cases fillet weld can be provided in slot or plug. So in the given figure you can see, Here likewise circular slot may be done, or this smaller size of plug, square shape or circular round shape plugs may be provided. So here in case of slot, the slot is made to the connecting plate and kept above the other plate to be connected, and welding is provided circumferentially to the length of slot. Here welding is not provided for the entire slot, only the welding is done in circumferential way. While in case of second plug welding, the plug or hole which is taken into the connecting plate, entire hole is filled with the help of welding. Here in case of plug, the hole is made either circular or rectangular and entire hole is filled with welding material. So this is the second type, that is slot welding and plug welding, and these are adapted only if the required length of welding cannot be provided for given section. And next we are going to see specification of welding. So this is as per clause number 10.5, page number 78 of IS 800 2007. So here the size of butt weld should be as per the width or depth of penetration, that root penetration that we have already seen. It depends upon whether the groove is provided for entire thickness or it is partially provided, and we have seen it is single V, double V, single U, double U, likewise or square type of joint. Now next specification is the effective throat thickness of fillet weld should not be less than minimum 3 mm and not exceed 0.7 to 1 T, where T is the thickness of thinner part. Again, maximum size of fillet weld is given as per your table number 21 of IS 800 2007, and this table is giving us thickness of thicker part, and range is given 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 32 and 32 to 50, and minimum size of welding is given here is equal to 3 mm. So based on the thickness of thicker part, you need to decide what is the size of welding. Now next, fillet welds terminating at the end should be written continuously around the corners for a length not less than 2 times size of welding. So in the figure you can understand here, this particular is your end written, at the bottom side also is end written. For a gusset plate, suppose this is trapezoidal gusset plate to which one flat is connected, and your welding is ending at this particular edge. So that particular edge is to be continued for a length of 2 times size of welding. So this particular 2 edges are to be of size 2 times size of welding. Similarly, next, minimum lap length for joint should not be less than 4 times T or 40 mm, whichever is more, where T is again thickness of thinner part. So this particular, this particular is your lap length. So member is to be lapped for minimum value of 40 or 400, whichever is more. And last specification, that is related with your intermittent welding. So usually in case of your girders, continuous welding is cannot be provided. So instead of going for continuous welding, we may go for intermittent welding. So certain slots of welding is done. So for that slot, minimum length required is 4 times size of weld or 40 mm. And spacing between this slot of welding should not exceed 12 times T or 16 times T, or in no case should be greater than 200 mm. So minimum length is 4 times size of weld or 40 mm, or spacing should be not less than 200 mm. Now next we are going to see design stress of weld. Now design stress of weld, as per IS 800 2007, designed weld strength shall be based on throat thickness and is given as FWD, designed weld strength. FWD stands for designed weld strength, equals to FWN divided by gamma MW. So this FWN is the nominal capacity of your strength weld, and gamma MW is partial safety factor, that is as per table given in IS 800. FWD stands for design strength of weld, FU stands for ultimate stress of weld material, and that is equal to 410, and if mild steel plate is used, it will be equal to 250 value. Now LE stands for length of weld, T stands for effective throat thickness, and that is always 0.7 times of size of welding, and gamma LW partial safety factor, that is 1.25 if it is weld in shop and 1.50 if it is weld at field. So on site welding, your gamma MW will be 1.50, and in shop welding, your gamma MW should be equal to 1.25. One more specification is given. Welding is to be done at the edges. So if the edge is square type of edge, here it is given the edge is square type, or it may be edge as rounded edge. So in case of square edge, your maximum size of welding should be, so thickness minus 1.5. Here minimum clearance of 1.5 mm is to be kept. So if you consider example of this angle size, if that angle is equal to thickness t, in that cases your weld size should be equal to t minus 1.5, and if the edge is rounded one, in that cases you should deduct 1/4 of thickness. So this particular 1/4 value and 1.5 mm is to be deducted from thickness of the element which is to be connected to parent material for considering or deciding the weld size. So likewise, these are the specification required for design of welding. So in the last two videos we were dealing with connections, introduction to connection, bolted type of connection, in that we have seen bearing type of connection, and in the current video we have seen welded type of connection, advantages, disadvantages, and what are the specifications required for the welded type of connection. In the next video we are going to solve some of the numericals based on connection types, that is welded type of connection and bolted type of connection. So thank you.